CH2CH2, abbreviated to that representation, where now we have two bonds, sigma and pi, and CH2 at each end. That's the molecule ethene. There is electron density across the centre of that molecule because the pair of electrons for that pi bond are occupying a particular region in space. You can see the second line there. It joins that part of the molecule. The principle of conjugation is that there can be situations where there is pi overlap, but you don't see it visually prompted in the structures. At the moment, you see there a double bond. And you see here a second double bond. And that is a start of understanding the true nature of butadiene. It does have two double bonds within it. But those two double bonds are adjacent to each other, which means that these pi bonding systems here are conjugated with one another. They in fact form a single, more extensive pi bonding system. We only write one line between those two central carbon atoms. But what I'm telling you on this slide is that there is still pi overlap across that central part, even though it is not written in any of the ways normally we write those structures out. There was our familiar starting point. I've pushed it off to the left-hand side of the slide now because there's a larger pattern building up here. Alkene, diene, you've just done butadiene. Triene, so we've got three alkenes represented in this structure. And this arene, this also has in its image three double lines representing two bonds between atoms. And in all of these cases, there is pi overlap in these structures, even though it's not drawn in the molecules. So conjugation is the overlap of pi electron density between adjacent regions where there is unsaturation in a structure. Now, glance down to the bottom of this slide. I put lowest in block capitals there. I've only drawn in this slide the lowest energy form for each of them. This is the lowest of two, that's the lowest of three, that's the lowest of a set of six. The lowest one always has the same crucial property, and that is that it is the most symmetric combination of the accompanying orbitals. So that means in these cases that at the top of the pi system, I've chosen to write plus on the first p orbital, and then as you work your way along these chains, there is no break in that pattern. It's plus across the top all the way along, an unbroken row. So regardless of how big the pi system is, the lowest energy one has no interruptions to this pattern of pluses around one side and minuses around the other. These structures retain the nodal plane of the individual p orbitals. All those nodal planes are lined up. And because it's pluses all the way along the top and minuses all the way along the bottom, there are no additional nodes in these lower energy structures.